Okay, we're back with more magazine to read. Still going. So, next game we're looking at is Minder. Oh, we lost it now. Where we? No, we're too late here. Yeah, here we go. It's better. Back with Minder. As Arthur Daly, you take place in the sleazy, underhand, double-dealing world of the London black market. You have 15 days in which to concoct as many shady deals and make as much folding green stuff as possible. You start at home with £2,000 and four possible destinations. Each of these, you will see a small graphic representation in the middle of the screen with the faces of those present on either side. Below is a box in which you can have conversations with people either at your instigation or theirs. Yeah, pretty much it's just a trading game. If you can stand the theme music from the TV show for a while, yeah, you'll probably do alright with the game, maybe. Anyway, it's 78%, so that's pretty decent, I guess. Should be. But, let's get started then. Let's see this day yet. Okay. Safety Sanctuary Industry. £2,000. Inventory. Oh, we've got stuff. Home computers. £47. Those are some cheap computers. Must be Spectrums. So the first thing we probably do is probably sell some of these for some profit, hopefully. Get somewhere. Get a dealer. Take all, I guess hopefully he'll take all. This is not open. Wait till he does open. Those will be dollars when he opened. Waiting a lot here. There we go. What's the deal? Maybe we'll sell these computers. We'll five of them as well. See what happens. Not sure what you're driving at. Still not certain what you're I should probably re-look at the manual, I guess, just to remind myself now. Find the manual first now. We should probably have prepared a bit better, perhaps. It says all conversations have a purpose to buy, sell, or give instructions, etc. And provided you stick to the point, you should manage well. Well, I'm gonna be able to play this damn game now. Okay. One. Oh. Thief. Go somewhere else then. Oh yeah, that's more fascinating and scrutable. Oh, you should know how to play this game. Late to wait now. Yeah. Oh, shoot the windshield. If I maybe we'll buy something. I'm in a buying mood. Yeah, but try. Try the other way around then. Still not sure what you mean. Try the internal widget, see how that works better. I think we'll go. Ah, jeez. This is what we've got, so... Wait. got something to steal up your sleeve. How do we start selling shit? Started with selling, is it? Start with, I've got some, are you interested in, want to buy any? Okay, see how that works in. And I can't type. Sorry, I gotta see you, man, about another deal. Oh. Well, that was a productive day. I guess you just go home and start the next day. No, this game's not French. This game was actually written by Don Priestley, who also did Popeye. Likes his big sprites. Usually, this is very different to that. Five home computers, they're not quite kosher. Don't let me catch you with them. Oh, okay. We need to dump that lot. Well, How about we just say yes? What difference is it gonna make? How many do I even have? I've forgotten. We'll sell 10. Let's see how far we get. Going well. Let's hit the club. Maybe something, get something done there. Got a dog. Are you Lobby Lud?
No.
Can but try. Sure, I'll take it. What do you say, yes? Now, didn't we just agree on this? I forget how many do I have. I have 20, right? At least. Place is closed. Go to Terry's vet, tell him to deliver the stuff. Oh, sure, whatever. You probably dump those computers at some point, I guess, maybe. Let's do it tomorrow! What's gonna happen? Okay. So I think everything. This is walking. Oh, I've got 80 of the damn things. I should have gone with that, shouldn't I? Walking boots. I'll get home now. There we are. When you take all say those thingamies are stuck together in clumps. He's only paid me half. Am I supposed to walk cut? That's £45. That's 45, here you are. Anything else? Dump them. Throw away. Cheerio. Okay. So we can find something to buy. Us. other groups the name. Oh dear. Girly mags! What? So people with a very kinky and bundles of 20 made for slobberers. Okay. How much? So 35 pounds? Ouch. How many? 60 on offer. How many after? We'll take 25. Offer. He's looking for 60 quid. We'll go for. He'll take 40. That's 35. No, you go for 40. Don't worry, perhaps some other. Pretty off at 6. Knowing anything about home computers, 5 home computers, that nips. Don't let me catch you for the mister, right? We got rid of them. Okay. Yes. Scabby Painting? Good name. Guaranteed waterproof to 50 feet solid stainless. Made by Rolex Oyster. How many? 120. We'll take 50 of them. $12. Lovely. We have a deal. 50 wrist chronometers at 12 quid each. Yeah, £600, yes? Yes. Sure. Nice bit of business. Pay on collection. Click within 3 days. Bye. Oh, another deal here, yes? Sleazy Tipple, trustworthy name. Rubber wetsuits, wonderful merchandise, range of colours, great for the rain. Made of pliable rubber. £25 on offer, how many are you after? I'll just take 10. It'll be okay. What price can you offer? $95 solves. Is that a bit much? Is that the right key? We'll make it 60, see what happens. Oh, here we go. We went for 60. Hey, Rob, is it 60 quid? I don't have much money left, am I now? Collection. Collection in 2 days. Hello. No, there's Terry right there. Yours are down the dump. Collect. Suits. And what the hell did we just buy before? I've forgotten already. Oh yeah, wrist chronometers, that's it. That's how you spell it. Cheerio. Did he do it? I think everything's going to be closed at this point. Back to the club. Let's just stay here all day. sure what you're on about. These are walking boots, have I got that right? Yes. It's 4 quid for them. Okay. Oh, 5 quid. Whatever. Still at 5 quid. What you got? 5, wasn't it? Railway. See you around. Can you actually go to the lockup? So. Oh, there's a good poster there. Wonderful. There you go. To collect, to deliver. Oh yeah, I've got 50 of those things. Okay, to collect rubber wetsuits. Time is 10 o'clock. Home. Okay, I'm gonna head to Terry's flat. Yeah, this is the first game tonight. It's game with very good names in it. What? Pretty specific, aren't I? Says it's shot. Is that the cash then? Plus a new quid for me. Gonna do it right away. Cheerio. Okay. So hopefully we can make some money with for these wetsuits here. Place open. Front clock apparently. Oh, you made it, Arthur. I'm broke. You must try. Suits, yes? Yes! 30 quid a piece? Oh yeah, robbery. Okay. I managed 45 quid. giving you a 45 per... We have to review this deal. I'm not really making any money on this, am I? Like only wetsuits, probably no. Oh well, gotta get rid of those now too. Should never trust someone named Sleazy Tipple. I've got company. Before I get moody. That's not how you spell it. Way out. it much lower, really. I think 5 is a fair price. Yeah. I don't think so then. You're waffling. Alright. Too bad. Ta-da. Fine, he paid in full. Minus most full cut. It's 130. Here you are. Want anything else? No, that's it. Oh yeah. Alright. With suits. I'll get on it right away. See you around. The widget you sold me were not up to standard. I don't appreciate that. So get lost. It's closed. Oh well. Time to go home. I'm gonna make money eventually, right? Got 27.35 pairs of walking boots to get rid of. Let's see. Lovely poster again. Nothing to deliver. We've got to go here to see what to click and what needs to be clicked or delivered. Anyway, just making sure nothing needed to be done. Okay, it's 1 hour. It's useless. Yeah, we should not get very far. We just maintain really stupid hours. Down a mine shaft. Anything else? Nope. See you around. Well, I used to be better at this. I used to remember a lot more details about this, but it's been a while. Yep, well, pretty much. Is that 2000? Trying to remember the hours that the dealers are open is not easy. I know I paid 12. No one's offering that much though. Jeez. I'm good at this. and widgets. You know, the widgets aren't all that great, might not get full price for them anyway. Let's see, boots, £25 at £7 for the boots. I'm about to go home now. Okay. Terry's got the money now. Douglas says those watches are rusty. He only paid me half. That's my little cut's 158 here you are. Oh. Anything else? Nope. Cheerio. Time to open the beauty, wasn't it? Yes. £4. £12. About £5. £10. I made £6. £8. It's a deal, £8. Here we go. Here you go. 50, wasn't it? We got 50, didn't we? Wasn't it? Was it 25? Well, well, never mind. I'm sure nothing will happen. Yeah, I got 25. That's gonna be a problem. Oh well. I keep saying external wizards for internal. £12. £5 each. £10. Made £6. £8. Whatever. It's sad with them. Didn't cost me anything. Got 80. That much I remember. Yes. I'm cool, so call me Barney. Bottles of booze, crates of whiskey, a lovely Luna. Fantastic merchandise. Gotta kick like a camel. 10 to the Crack, made by Johnny Runner. Oh, I see what they did there. Okay. £916. £77?! That sounds expensive. £40 sounds a lot cheaper. Disgusting, but we're £45. I'll take it. £45 is £200. Yes, yes. Pay on collection. Pay in 4 days. Bye. I don't want to buy any more now. Beg your pardon? Now, it's been nearly an hour and I'm still playing this. Tunk says there weren't enough, so we'll come back. Oh, what? Anything else? Deliver widgets. Well, cereal. At least I got the amount right. The widgets is 80. Okay. Those thingamies are stuck together in clumps. You only pay me half. That's why some small cut. That's 288. Here you are. Okay. Anything else? Gotta clean things, haven't we? Clear. Oh, whiskey, that's it. Oh, you what? Sometimes. Do we have bottles of whiskey? It's just whiskey. I'll go now. Cheerio. Yeah. Do we have crates of whiskey. Well, at least it's in the bottles. £545. Now we gotta find someone to sell them to. The studio open. Okay. That's a waste of a day. Sell me. Sozzled. Did he sell it or not? Well, I guess he probably wants to buy something. Do some videos. Video recorders. Fantastic offer. Remote control. Front loading. Made by Hitachi. Okay. Nice. £115? How many? 15 available. Go for 5. 5 it is. A bit of a fair offer. £115. £40. 68 is all I'm asking. 45. Great! Okay, well, 5 video recorders at £45 each. Yep. A bit of business, pound collection. And hold for 4 days. Bye. Barney, they're in the lockup. Anything else? Did I do something wrong? I was trying to think something not right now. Check here. Take video was to deliver. Right. That's what I was supposed to deliver, the boots. What, Arthur? You never sold any bottles of booze. Yeah. Okay. What? Got the whiskey, got the boots. £20? Wait, 45? dinner for me, yes? Yes. Right away. Okay, good. I'll click the video recorders too. Closed. Fine, you paid in full. But he's 216, here you are. Yay, money! Spider Dingle's the name. Good name. Corsets, men's corsets, very nice, superior quality, bone reinforced, with oil can, made by Camel Lead. Okay. How much? Well, these corsets are only 9 quid. $150 on offer. Well, this could be a dump. We'll go for $100. £2. Here. I'll say 6 quid. £3. No, £3 ain't enough. £4. £5. You're one short. Okay. Right, £6. Got 2 collected. The delivery should be in progress, right? There he is. Right, those boots. Larry Tonk says they weren't enough, so they'll all come back. Well, I think my memory needs work. click video record. one at a time, apparently. The bartender needs... Tell's looking for something about videos. One on the slate. On the house. Can I give a free, It's crazy, the whiskey you sold were nicked. The law turned me over. So on your bike. At least you didn't get violent. You can do that too, I suppose. That's what I got rid of them, I suppose. Oh, whatever the hell, corsets, corsets. You're going to notice. £10. £4. About £9. I'm going about £4. £8. Now for you missing the... Cheer out. Knotted. It's an insult. have I got that right?
Yes.
How much?
Over 12 pounds.
About 6 quid, ooh.
10.
7.
Make it 8.
The deal 8 quid.
How many have you got?
100.
Give yourself.
Take 60.
Okay.
No.
Oh,
oh,
I thought you were.
Of course, it's from Spider Dingle.
You're in the lockup.
House.
Live for the corsets.
Spend them with me,
yes.
Yes.
Right away.
Okay.
I can afford to buy anything at this point.
Feed him again.
And he paid you his corsets are fine, he paid in full.
Good.
Here we go, some money. Anything else?
No.
It's way too long. We did it last day anyway, so. Let's just have do the fun bit, shall we?
We get
punched. It's always the good part. Let's see.
You're asking for aggro! Take that punch!
I've lost 4 trading days. That's one way to get through the game quicker. Out of time.
Your score, 502 pounds.
Final word from the master. Oh dear, not even your original stake. How useless. Why don't you try Oxfam?
Good.
Anyway. I'm gonna get on to the next one, we'll always be here for ages. Destroy!
Thank you for destroying.
Come on, here we go. Yeah. Okay.
We can go on to the next magazine.
Next game. Which is Spannerman. A nuclear reactor is about to turn a large chunk of Britain hotter than a vindaloo. So who do they call in to save the day? The local plumber, of course. Needless to say that you and your job as a plumber is to tighten all the joints in the pipes of the reactor cooling system. There are 4 pipes on four levels of the screen, each with 5 joints, which have to be tightened with your spanner. If they start leaking, the water collects at the bottom of the screen and you can only spend so much time submerged. Giant mutated rats are flushed out by the water, and you can kick these to stop them killing you. The earthquake that started the trouble is still going, and the occasional chunk of debris will drop from the ceiling and kill you if you get in the way. Good news, economy of effort and fast work required. Bad news, only a 1-screen game, and you can't actually win. But 43%, I'm not sure it deserves that, but
it's get that loaded then.
Okay. Okay. Another game by our friend C. Hunt. Okay. Instructions. So I'll select the window. Instructions. Your local power station has had a major failure. The nuclear reactor cooling system has been damaged during an earthquake. There have been some problems with the repairs, and you, the village plumber, have been called in to assist. The pipes containing the coolant are developing leaks from the many joints in the system. Your job is to cure the leaks using your trusty spanner and save the nearby town from certain disaster. There are, however, some dangers to be wary of before you begin your mission. The cooling water that leaks from the system has nowhere to go because the drains are all blocked during the earthquake. The water level will rise at a speed which is dependent on the current leakage. You can hold your breath for a short period and go under the water to repair leaks. The rising water level also disturbs a resident colony of rats. They have lived in the reactor for some time and mutate into giant antimatter rats. If you get too close to them, that is the end of both of you. Oh, yeah, yeah, miss getting punched out. Oh, well. Oh, well. Page. You are fortunately wearing your steel cap boots, and they provide you with a means of defense against the rats. One kick usually puts an end to the most stubborn rat. This behavior does not go down too well with the local Wildlife Preservation Society, who are attempting to save this endangered species. Consequently, if you kill too many rats, the points allocated will decrease. One final word of warning. The leaky joints will normally require several pulls on the spanner before the leak is sealed, but over-tightening can sometimes result in a broken bolt. This leak will be almost impossible to repair. Almost. Okay. The control of Spannerman can be via the keyboard or a joystick plugged into the first port. Top tip, there's only one port. More details of the control actions and the choice of operating keys are given in options. Don't forget that you are right-handed. You are allowed 3 men per game, and a bonus man will be given if you cure all the leaks on the screen or score more than 20,000 points. By the way, the earthquake is not quite over yet, so watch out for falling debris. In our options screen. Okay. Firing up, firing down. Firing up to jump up, or left and right. Firing down to kick a rat. You use the joystick keyboard. Joystick. Okay, here we go. Different level. We'll stick with one. Just for fun. Kick. Got him. Hard to time those. So. Turn around! Well, start again. This helps or anything, but whatever. Oh, if you time that right. On that right either. Oh, do another try. See, that makes it easier. Whee! Yeah, okay, jumping's a little easier. Oh! That was fair. Do we know more rats on this level? Can we hold our breath and fix more leaks? Yeah, that was fair. You just have to set the rat to spawn on top of you. One more attempt. Ooh, we'll give it one more attempt. Oh, that's not fair. Just overdo this. I did, didn't I? Oh! It's not really fair. fair, is it?
Oh.
We get the idea of the game. It's that, pretty much. Okay, well, head to the... back to the magazine, get on the next game. Next game is Traffic. Yes, this is traffic control, pretty much. Just go control traffic flow. A quick thinking, cool head is required. An original and interesting game idea. Yeah, well, it's original, I'll give it that. Car movement and sound effects are good. Okay. Only a one-screen game, although the layouts change. Directing the traffic may get boring. How would you like to be a traffic cop? It's always like rush hour. It's always like rush hour at the Hangar Lane gyratory system. 46%. Yeah, basically you just got to control traffic lights, pretty much. So. A shot. Screen monitor. No. Traffic. You've been given the job of head traffic controller in London. You must keep all the traffic flowing, allowing cars to pass across the screen. Use a cursor to select which road junction you are to controlling. Press the fire button to change the lights, but beware, if the traffic jams get too long, you lose. Successfully control the traffic, and you will graduate to more difficult parts of the city. Okay, good title screen. Thank you. Start. It was a demo. Okay. This is pretty much the game. I think we've got a traffic jam already. Oh, did we fail? No, we graduated, apparently. Well, I think I lost. Hey, high school. 383. Oh, we have the initials like this. That's an N for reasons. I think we get the idea of this game, so... We'll move on to the next. Next game is Haunted Hedges. Visions of Pac-Man have always been in abundance, but this one is in pseudo 3D. Makes it all the different, I'm sure. This does predate Pac-Mania, I guess. The maze is constructed of hedges which actually have depth so that you can go behind them. When moving through a gap, you have to remember it is in perspective. The aim is to guide your stick man around the maze, picking up gold coins, munching dots, while avoiding the four guardians, ghosts. Once you start your man moving in a direction, he keeps going until he hits a wall, so you have to keep alert for guardians coming the other way. The objects that appear for bonus points, fruits, while getting an ice axe, power pill, will let you chase the ghosts for a short time and try to send them back to their base for a bonus. Good news, increasing difficulty. Pac-Man has always been addictive. Okay. Bad news, poor graphics and animation. Very unoriginal. So despite it being in 3D as such, 33% for graphics. 43% overall. We'll give it a go. Okay. So I did write down what set to actually use. Here we go. Now is the correct one. Focal pack 1.bin, that tells you something, I guess. Intelligence of ghosts. Yeah, okay. Oh, we've got instructions. The object of the game is to steer yourself around the maze collecting the gold coins for points. 10 points per dot. And you must avoid the four ghosts, they literally are ghosts, which are out to eat you. You can defend yourself with one of the four ice picks. Upon collecting one, the ghosts will turn white with fear and run away from you. You score the following bonuses for each ghost you catch. 200, 400, 800, 1600. You know, the scoring system's original. Throughout the game, random treasures appear for extra bonuses. Treasure chest, 200 points. Sapphire, 500 points. Talisman, 1,000 points. When you've collected all the dots and used all the ice axe, you will progress to the next level where there are more dots and the ghosts even more faster. Upon scoring 20,000 points, you will gain an extra life. Have lots of fun! Yeah, sure we will. Okay. Tree stick. Okay. Here we go. This is it. I think the ghosts do actually kind of come after you as well. Best idea to get as many dots as you can while the ice axe is in effect. Ooh. Oh geez, they come after you in there. Sound effects. Mentioned I'm terrible at Pac-Man. No. Well. Yeah, that's the game. It's Pac-Man, alright. Could be worse, I guess. Anyway, we'll just move on to the next. It's, you can tell what that is. The next game is Quack A Jack. Get our first Paul Shirley game. It's you're trapped in a 16-level dungeon where monsters pursue you around as you try to crush eggs before they hatch. The problem is that the floor crumbles away after you've walked on it, and with 5 eggs to get, you've got to tread carefully. You appear as a duck, and there is a time limit in which you must get each egg before it hatches into a deadly pterodactyl. That's a word. If your route is blocked by a gap you have to where you previously walked, then you can shift the row of floor to make a path. The screen wraps around, but you have to watch out for the wacky but deadly inhabitants and cooking pots to avoid blundering into them. There's treasure to be collected on each screen. Once you have 5 eggs, once 5 eggs have been destroyed, you move on to a screen with more monsters. Good news, fast thinking and planning needed. Panic action against increasing odds. Bad news, not much depth to the game. You can only move rows and not columns of the floor. It wouldn't be too easy now, would you? 67%. Okay. Set up here. Okay. Here's Quack A Jack. Now, Quack A Jack is based on the FRP game Fandonia. I'm going to press 1, 2, or 3. We'll just start. So you can wrap around. Okay, one stage. Those ghosts look filthy. Kevin the Prawn on a drinking spree. Brought the space hopper. Bonus duck. Watch out for Sue's nose. Whoever Sue is. Well, yeah, that's probably a mistake. Oh, stupid nose. No. Damn it. These burgers look fresh, or is it raw? Down under Velros Castle. But, well, went too far, I guess. Thank you. Okay. Well done, new high score. Yeah, okay. Suit level. Easy, or hard masochist. Easy, hard masochist. We'll just leave it at that, I guess. We'll give it another one more try. Vampire Rabbit's Lair. Ghosts look filthy. Kevin the Prawn on a drinking spree. The space hopper. What is the space hopper's a happy? No, I didn't walk into that. That was stupid. Stuck. Watch out for Sue's nose. fresh, or was it raw? Valros Castle. Is that a lame duck or was it an Aurak? No. Can we go very far there? Stomp, stomp, stomp. I bet they smell too. Oh, well, yeah, well, it's the game, it's a pretty decent fun really, so. It's only well worth a good play every now and again. Okay, it's head back to the magazine. Still got time. Yeah. Okay. The next game is Jammin. Rankin Rodney has to get together four instruments in order to get that groove sound. He has to do it amongst the garish moving colours of the instrument dumping ground. There are 20 screens made up of a patchwork of four colours. One instrument will correspond to each colour zone and has to be picked up and brought back to the centre of the screen where a triangle flashes to indicate its place. The patchwork is arranged into a maze with moving belts and colours which transport you around until you want to get off. Things aren't easy though, since you've got some non-musical enemies to contend with. Bum notes will send your instrument back to the start if they want. if they get you, will distortions steal it and play totally out of key. Discords are the worst, and if you're under them, you lose a life. Each screen has a time limit, and if you haven't got all four instruments together, you'll lose a life. The tunes change from each screen as do the mazes, but each tune is best when you've got an instrument, since it plays the full tune with a drum beat, bass, and harmony. Good news! Fantastic music with many different tunes. Garishly colourful graphics. That's good. Novel gameplay and scenario. Bad news, the colours and gameplay may not appeal to all. At 95% in sounds, it's going to be worthwhile music then. Anyway, let's get it started then. He says as the lights just flicker a bit for unknown reasons. Oh well, let's see. Okay. It breaks into it, huh? You run it again? Yes. Jammin. By task set. Ah, flashing colors! Okay, so change the joystick, one player, fire to play, let's go. Stole the okay, that's one. Damn it. damn it. Two or not? No, still at the last minute, huh? Fear. This game is so fear. I don't think it would be fair to steal anything, do they? Well, you can't get close at all, can you? Can't get close, can you? Wow, this game's hard. Try again. Thank you. is three. Game is getting annoying. Now, finally, why don't you finish the stage? Oh, we're going to do that. Let's do it all again. Infuriating. Fuck off. Shoot. No, go away. Hey, thanks for the raid, Kettle. this is a game. Long way here, huh? Okay, that's three. One more. I don't get back in. Oh, I walked through it. Oh, do it all again. Thank you. Oh, really? It has to get that close. Second damn stage. What? Really? Throwing me nuts. It's a game, all right. Okay. Well, this game's hard. Not sure I really want to play too much more of it. Anyway, back to the magazine. Switch back to the next game we've got is Binky. A cross between Q-Bert and Painter. Yeah. sets you the task of changing the colour of a 3D floor layout by walking over it. There are 21 layouts which have to be painted, and the later ones require 2 or even 3 coats of paint. You change the colour of a part of the floor just by walking over it and repeating the action if more than one coat is needed. The trouble is that the floor was floating around in mid-air and populated by some nasty little creatures. Binky moves quite fast, and consequently, you have to be very alert not to run off the edge of the floor, where he will fall to his death. The other dangers that await him are little flat red monsters, bigger green monsters, and some decidedly nasty killer balls. Yeah. The flat creatures appear on the floor, and after hesitating for a moment, move in one direction, and they hit Binky or run into the edge of the floor where they disappear. Green beasts are altogether nastier since they home in on you. They appear first a stationary green circle with a number counting down on them. Once they hatch, they make a beeline for you. They can be stopped by running over them before they hatch or gliding to a hole where they fall through. The balls are more intelligent still and will avoid the holes by making life very difficult indeed. You are told some nice cheat modes to use on the game, but for me this seemed to spoil the challenge. The game tells you the cheats? Interesting. Good news, colourful graphics, fast reflex action, clever screen layouts and enemies. Bad news, official cheat mode spoils the challenge. Frustratingly easy to run off edge of floor, not a very original game concept. 60%! Okay. Get that set up then. Okay. Loading! Invulnerability! No! Infinite lives! No! Let's get a built in cheat mode! Skill levels and pressing control L! No! Okay. Press space to play! Is A up left? I think I did have to use keyboard for this. There's no joystick support for this thing. Oh, wrong direction. Oh, look at this. Here we go. Straight, this is keyboard check. Oh. Keys not in logical positions. Oops, that's not your dodge. This game's hard. And you could redefine the keys, that'd be good. Jumped in the hole. Hey, we finished the stage. Oh, really? Really? Okay. See if we can get a bit further. Okay. Oh god, has this thing got moving platforms? Oh boy. Oh, hooked off. Thank you. time. Oh, jeez. This is not going to be fun. Oh, no. Well, platforming sucks. It's a stupid idea for this game. Well, I think that's enough of Pig Cubert. Binky Busters. Okay. Let's just get back to the. We'll do one last game. I think next game is one we want to get out of the way. Because it's a stupid game. Yeah, it's Roland on the Run. Roland is escaping from Amsoft. Can you blame him with games like this? And is stowed away on a train. You have to get him and up to 254 others, big train, off the train and into their hideouts via some passing lorries. There is only one screen with a detailed scrolling background. A train in the middle, lorries and cars going both ways on a road, and the hideouts at the bottom. You can control the speed of the train to match that of the first row of lorries. And when a man on the train flashes, jump him onto a lorry. It's not in between them like I did when I first played this. You wonder how this game works. When a man in a lorry flashes, you can jump him to lorries travelling in the opposite direction and from there to the hideout. You have up to 255 lives and you lose one every time you miss a jump. On tougher levels, the traffic speeds up and slows down to make your task even harder. Good news, excellent high-res colour display. Bad news, boring repetitive gameplay. Stickman character graphics. Timing of jumps isn't made clear. Graphics. I don't know, what have we got graphics here for? 29%. So you know it's going to be good. One last game hype. Yes. Get the annoying game out of the way. Another Egypt game, so you know it's going to be good. Ooh, got music. Oh, is that it? Okay. Yeah. Greater than accelerate the train, less than greater than decelerate the train. Z, X, and C to jump from first line. We'll jump between traffic. Well, number of lives 1 to 255. We'll start with. We'll just start with 20. See how far we get. Select level 1. So yeah, we can train go fast. Train slow down. Okay. Confusing. for our lives. We're not getting anywhere. Yeah, I've lost. Try again. This is level one. Yeah, it's just... This game is very, very confusing. How do we get down to the... Let's bring up this train a bit. Here we go. Did he make it? Hard to tell. Well, this is a game. The reason why you want to get it out of the way. I don't know, I can't tell. Are you supposed to get across, sir? Really? Oh, jeez. What? Utterly confusing. I have no idea what's going on, really. Well, I know what's going on, it's just... Oh, that was too early. Is there any space to... Oh, really, such as... Whenever female feels like it. Yeah, this is the last attempt. This is not really feeling this game at all. switch when you damn well feel like it, sure. Sure, when you're supposed to get do that last line, it's annoying. Oh, you gotta get in there. Alright. Into the whatever those are on the side of the not between them. Move when they're flashing, so here we go. Very excited. Oops. Oh, really? Train. Oh. Push no for another game, for not playing another game. Oh. Little break. I guess this game was written in basic, but it's not letting me escape into it. Oh, never mind. Ooh. So I'll leave it there.